There is an I'm just going to run it through once and then we'll. Let's take it from sing a song. Ready? Go.
Sing a song.
Good morning and welcome to St. Bernard Lake Catholic Church on the second Sunday of Lent. Our opening song will be Lord, Be Throughout These 40 Days, number 40 in the Lead Me, Guide Me hymnal. Number 40 in the Lead Me, Guide Me hymnal, Lord, Be Throughout These 40 Days.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning, all. Welcome to the second Sunday of Lent. We continue to journey in this special season, praying for God's mercy and grace. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who have commanded us to listen to your beloved Son, be pleased, we pray, to nourish us inwardly by your word, that with spiritual sight made pure, we may rejoice to behold your glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. God put Abraham to the test. He called to him, "Abraham." "Here I am," he replied. Then God said, "Take your son Isaac, your only one, whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah. There you shall offer him up as a holocaust on a height that I will point out to you." When they came to the place of which God had told him, Abraham built an altar there and arranged the wood on it. Then he reached out and took the knife to slaughter his son. But the Lord's messenger called out to him from heaven, "Abraham, Abraham." "Here I am," he answered. "Do not lay your hand on the boy," said the messenger. "Do not do the least thing to him. I know now how devoted you are to God, since you did not withhold from me your own beloved son." As Abraham looked about, he spied a ram caught by its horns in a thicket, and offered it. So he went and took the ram and offered it up as a holocaust in place of his son. Again, the Lord's messenger called out to Abraham from heaven and said, "I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that because you acted as you did in not withholding from me your beloved son, I will bless you abundantly and make your descendants as countless as the stars in the sky and the sands of the seashore. Your descendants shall take possession of the gates of their enemies, and in your descendants all the nations of the earth shall find blessing. All this because you obeyed my command." The word of the Lord.
In the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones. I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living. O Lord, I am your servant. I am your servant, the son of your handmaid. You have loosened my bonds. To you I will offer sacrifice of thanksgiving, and I will call upon the name of the
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, if God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but handed him over for us all, how will he not also give us everything else along with him? Who will bring a charge against God's chosen ones? It is God who acquits us. Who will condemn? Christ Jesus, it is who died, or rather was raised, who also is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. The word of the Lord.
Praise and glory to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. Praise and honor to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. From the shining cloud, the Father's voice is heard. This is my beloved Son, listen to him. Praise and honor to you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus took Peter, James, and John and led them up a high mountain apart by themselves. And he was transfigured before them. And his clothes became dazzling white, such as no fuller on earth could bleach them. Then Elijah appeared to them, along with Moses, and they were conversing with Jesus. Then Peter said to Jesus in reply, "Rabbi, it is good that we are here. Let us make three tents, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." He hardly knew what to say. They were so terrified. Then a cloud came, casting a shadow over them. From the cloud came a voice. "This is my beloved Son. Listen to him." Suddenly, looking around, they no longer saw anyone, but Jesus alone with them. As they were coming down from the mountain, he charged them not to relate what they had seen to anyone, except when the Son of Man had risen from the dead. So they kept the matter to themselves, questioning what rising from the dead meant. The Gospel of the Lord. You may be seated.
Going through the readings of today, the second Sunday of Lent. through the three readings. What struck me in a very personal manner, which I would also like to share with you, is the relationship between glory and sacrifice. The relationship between glory and sacrifice. So the theme of our reflection today is glory comes with sacrifice. When you take your time to read through the scriptures, there's one particular fact that's constant. In mathematics, we may call it a constant, a factor, a constant factor. And that is, whenever God invites human beings into a relationship, when God says, "Follow me," it entails sacrifices. Read through, beginning with Moses, the prophets, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, and all of them. Get into the New Testament. You talk of Peter, Andrew, James, and John. Check the conditions in which they were called. You look at Zacchaeus. You check the story of Matthew. You look at the story of our mother, the Blessed Virgin Mary. Look at Mary Magdalene. Look at Martha and Mary. And almost all of them, when God says, "Follow me," it entails sacrifices. You can't run away from it. The story of the transfiguration read in the gospel today has a lot of messages and lessons for us about our journey with God, about the heavenly race. It has a lot of stories. But among these lessons we could derive from this particular story is that humans have the penchant of jumping into glory. Amen? Humans have the penchant. We love glory so much. But we also have the penchant to boycott the cross or the sacrifices. Immediately, Peter saw the glory. He has never seen it before. He said, "Master, I have not seen this kind of glory before. Can we just build three booths? One for you, one for Elijah, one for Moses. Even if we are outside under the winter, we don't mind. Let's just continue to say this." But the answer and the attitude of Jesus told him otherwise. And it's also a direction for us today. If you want the glory, be ready to carry the cross. If you want the glory, be ready to do the sacrifice. If you are not ready to do the sacrifice, if you are not ready to carry the cross, forget the crown. Because no cross, no crown. In the first reading of today, taken from Genesis chapter 22, the Bible tells us how the crown of Abraham came. The story tells us how the crown of Abraham came. Today we call him our father in faith. The Muslims are appropriating him as their father. The Jews are appropriating him as their father. The Christians are appropriating him as their father. We are like dragging Abraham. The Muslims are saying, oh, he is our father. The Jews are saying, oh, he's our father. The Christians are saying, oh, he's the father in faith. He's running a car. So most of the times we want to share in Abraham's blessing, but most of the times, a whole bunch of us don't want to share in his sacrifices, don't want to go with him through the road of the cross. Before that crown is being won. Have you ever put yourself in Abraham's shoes? Have you ever sat down, took up Abraham's story, removed Abraham, put yourself in the place of Abraham? Let's look at it a little bit. This is a man who was promised a son. When he was 75, had to wait for 25 years for that son to come when he was 100. Can you think about it a little bit? You were given a promise, and he stayed for 25 years for that promise to be delivered to you. If you made an order in Amazon or whatever, if it takes like 1 month, you may even cancel the order. Find another shop to go and make the order. But Abraham, he did not even make an order. God made the order in his, on his behalf, and it took 25 years for it to be delivered. Secondly, when he got this order, this son was born to him. The only hope of his succession. He was very happy. You could put yourself in Abraham's shoes, sitting down and looking at Isaac running around you, and you are very happy and like, oh, my future is secure. And boom, all of a sudden, one morning, you got a call. Hey, Abraham. You say, oh, yes, my Lord, thinking that he wants to tell you something very juicy. And he's like, oh, Abraham, take that to your son, your only hope for succession. Go, sacrifice him for me. You'll be like, what? What are you talking about? Thirdly, have you ever thought about Sarah in this whole case? Abraham had to carry this burden by himself. I don't know whether you have maybe seen this whole case, this whole story from this perspective, that he never told Sarah about what was happening. He had to carry this whole burden by himself. Because if he had told Sarah, there would have been a problem in paradise. It's like Mr. Tony telling his wife, oh, God said we should go and sacrifice the first son. Man, what are you talking about? Go and tell that your God, it's not going to happen. And then come to think of it, if Abraham had told Isaac, probably Isaac would have run away. Who wants to be sacrificed like an animal? No, he will run away. So Abraham had to carry this whole burden by himself. Even when the son suspected something and asked, Father, we have the firewood. There is a knife. Where is the ram for the sacrifice? I say, oh, the Lord will provide. This guy had to carry this whole burden by himself. So, looking at Abraham from our human perspective, it wasn't easy for the guy, but the Bible recorded it in a manner that looks very simple. It was not easy for the guy. This guy was someone having flesh and blood like you and I. But he had to obey, even in that difficulty. Even in that sacrifice that he was told to go and do, he was also sacrificing his own peace of mind. He was also sacrificing his own tranquility. He was also sacrificing Abraham was crushed by that demand. But he had to go and do it because he trusts in God, who is his wonderful friend. So you see that obedience is not easy. Exercise of faith is not easy. No matter how you paint it, obedience is not easy. Exercise of faith is not easy either. When you come to the second reading, the same thing happens. God the Father did not spare his only son for a greater good. And what is that greater good? That death is destroyed and salvation is guaranteed. That man is saved from sin and damnation and condemnation. And then man is restored to his former glory. That is the same trajectory of events playing out here. That Jesus becomes like a replacement or a prototype or a typology of Isaac, who was ordinarily sacrificed because already Abraham has lifted up his hands before God said, no, don't do it. I now know you trust me. So Jesus is like standing in the place of Isaac. Some theologians have come up with some kind of theologizing, let me use the word, like saying that God is a horrible father. And why will any good father sacrifice his son for the good of others? See that interpretation? God is a horrible father. How would any good father sacrifice his son for the good of others? But then one thing that has occurred to me and keeps occurring to me is, when we do theology, having in mind that we understand everything about God, we are lying to ourselves because we cannot understand everything about God. If we do theology thinking that with our finite wisdom that we could understand the infinite wisdom of God, then we are lying to ourselves. Or if we do theology forgetting that this same God who is the foundation of our theologizing has said, your ways are not my ways, and my ways are not your ways, then we are lying to ourselves. This particular argument has dominated the theological discussion for quite years and decades, and is still there. But one thing we have to understand is, the wisdom of God is above whatever we think is the wisdom of man. So he does his things his own way. So when we, in our finite wisdom, start questioning the infinite wisdom of God, then we have a problem. We are overstepping our boundary. But then the church draws these three readings together today to tell us something. We are in the Lenten season. And the agenda is, draw closer to God. Have an intimate relationship with God. This is what this whole Lenten thing is all about. The church is telling us today, if you want that glory of being closer to God, then be ready to sacrifice. If you are not ready to sacrifice, you can't wear the crown of being closer to God. If you want the glory of being a good child of God, and God has said, follow me, then look at the history of those who have followed God by his invitation. They all had to sacrifice, especially some of the ordinary human desires. We also have to do the same. So if you are having difficulty within this Lenten season, maybe certain things you have decided to sacrifice and you are finding it difficult. Yes, you are supposed to find it difficult because that is part of the sacrifice. Sacrifice is not easy. The cross is not easy. But then It is very, very important that we do them. So what are those things that are distracting you and inhibiting you having a good relationship with God? Those things, you need to sacrifice them. Some of them may have gotten into you and you have become addicted to them. You need to shed off. You need to cut off. Maybe social media, maybe Facebook. When you are thinking of God, when you go through that social media, it gives you another image of reality that is not according to God's plan. Why not shed it off? It may be that every time when you go to McDonald's, you are sitting down there, your breakfast is there, your lunch is there, your dinner is there. You have gotten addicted to it. Why not this time, I'll not go to McDonald's again. Let me do this sacrifice and self-discipline because of God and Lent. Some have gotten addicted to going to Costco. Every time you go to Costco, you see them there. Every week, they're going to Costco. Every week, you see them at Costco. You could this time say, I'm no longer going to Costco. There are a lot of things that have taken the place of your relationship with God that you could share. It's not going to be easy. But do that kind of sacrifice if you want that glory. And this also plays out in our own normal human life. If you want good health, you have to sacrifice for it by choosing a lifestyle that encourages that good health. You want a good job, you have to do the sacrifice. Go through the cross by acquiring the necessary skills for that good job. If you want a fulfilled lifestyle, a fulfilled life in the future, you have to sacrifice for it now. Some children are having a better life now because of the sacrifices their parents put into their life far back in their days. But the children of today may not be ready to do that sacrifice because they think everything is good for them. Who is going to suffer it? Maybe their children in the nearest future. Because you are enjoying the sacrifices of your parents now, but you don't want to put in your own sacrifice for your children to be better in the future. If you don't do it, man, oh my God, the result is going to come. And when it comes, you will see that if you want to wear the crown, you must put in the sacrifice. That is the trajectory of life. So we pray that Jesus may help us to put in the necessary sacrifice now for the anticipated glory. Because that is what he's telling us today. This Lenten season, let us do the much we could do to deny ourselves certain things that we enjoy, so that we tell God how serious we are in coming closer to him. May Jesus continue to help us. Amen.
May we profess our faith. I believe in one God, God from true God, begotten of man, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church.
I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. Prayer of the faithful. God demands us today to listen to his beloved Son. Let us pray for the grace to do so.
For the church, may all the faithful be open to the God of surprises, who calls us to trust in the promises of glory, even in the midst of difficulty and discouragement. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, may they enact laws and policies that promote and defend the dignity of all peoples. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who struggle with depression and despair, may they experience and know deeply the hope of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who seek transformation, may they find hope in Christ transfigured. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish community, may we continue to be a faithful reflection of the hope and peace that only come from Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those most in need of our prayers, especially for Walter Moret, may he rest in peace, and Kay Shavers for her health, and for all those who ask for our prayers, especially those in our prayer and petition books, that their prayers may be received and answered by our God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those prayers we hold in the silence of our own hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you for your words. Help us to realize that your invitation to be in a relationship with you demands sacrifices from us. Give us the grace to make such sacrifices. Help the young ones among us to know that life demands discipline, and may we have the strength to imbibe such disciplines through Christ our Lord.
Amen. You may be seated. Whether we find ourselves atop the mountain of success or in the dark valleys of despair, Jesus is always there with us. All we need do is turn to him in prayer. Please take a few moments to prayerfully consider your offertory gift to God and thanksgiving for the many blessings you have received this week.
Our offertory hymn is not in the hymnal, so please sit back and enjoy our children's choir performance of Days of Elijah.
Thank you. sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May this sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, cleanse us of our faults and sanctify your faithful in body and mind for the celebration of the Paschal festivities, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For after he had told the disciples of his coming death on the holy mountain, he manifested to them his glory, to show, even by the testimony of the law and the prophets, that the passion leads to the glory of the resurrection. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship, and constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim.
Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna.
The fount of all holiness, make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body to be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, to be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Archbishop, Matt, our auxiliary, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. And with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, to God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Praise and glory, amen. 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 Praise and glory.
The Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we are with the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory of God, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. My sisters and brothers, let us offer to one another a sign of God's peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Thank you.
Let us pray. Bless your faithful, we pray, O Lord, with a blessing that endures forever, and keep them faithful to the gospel of your only begotten Son, so that they may always desire and at last attain that glory whose beauty he showed in his own body to the amazement of his apostles, through Christ our Lord.
My goodness, we have so many of you here today. We didn't run out of hosts, but we ran out of music. Amen. Amen. And on that note, let's take a moment to affirm our young people. Wow. As well as our cantor. Thank you. Are there any birthdays? Any birthdays? All right.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday from St. Bernadette. Happy birthday to you.
Are there any anniversaries? Any anniversaries? Are there any visitors? Any visitors? Two in the back, all right. Stay standing, we sing to you.
Welcome.
Welcome.
Welcome to St. Bernadette. We say welcome.
Welcome,
welcome to St. Bernadette.
All are welcome. Amen, amen. Anytime you're in town, we know you have your own parish wherever you're from, but anytime you're in town, this is your parish from now on. Amen? Amen. They're nodding. Good. This is Lenten season. Please take some extra time for prayer and your own spiritual preparation for Easter. You can do 40 days of random acts of kindness or a couple per week. This can include paying for somebody else's meal at the drive-in or bringing baked goods to a shut-in neighbor or maybe just writing a nice note to a server who did an awesome job. Oh, yes, and leave a nice tip. Our Easter lily sales have begun. We'll talk about that a little bit again, but there are flyers by the doors. So if you're interested in Easter lilies, that would be wonderful because they benefit a great organization. Yes. The church is providing you with a wonderful Lenten opportunity also in the form of the grocery box giveaway. Just pick up a couple of cans or extra things of stuffing or whatever you happen to like. You don't have to spend a lot of money, but the next time you're at the grocery store, just throw a couple extra items in your cart, put them in the boxes by the doors. Tax season is upon us, well upon us. Updated contact information on your file with the parish office helps us assure we can get your information on your donations to us on a timely fashion. So with that, I'd like to take a moment and invite Tony Bacon up to for a brief announcement. Thank you, Tony.
Thank you, Deacon. Good morning. I'm here on behalf of the confirmation candidates for this year to talk about purchasing Easter lilies. The lilies will be placed on the altar in memory of a loved one for you. Purchasing a lily will also help the confirmation kids go on retreat this year. So there are, like the deacon said, there are flyers in the, on the side of the church here, on the back, and I'll be down in the hall today asking for your purchase of lilies. Thank you very much.
Those lilies are the lilies that we use to decorate our altar also at Easter. So the more you buy, the prettier it'll be. So with that, if you would like to be an informed parishioner, as I mentioned, visit our website, spbernadettela.org, or our Facebook page or Twitter, or simply pick up a paper copy of the parish bulletin. Before we end our time together, as we all know, today, this month is Black History Month. And we'd also invite you to please stand as we sing the anthem for Black History, led by our youth choir, Let Every Voice Sing.
Number 291 in the Lead Me, Guide Me hymnal, number 291.
And please remain standing for the final blessing.
May we once again appreciate this. These little angels, I'm happy when I hear their voices. May we appreciate them, please. Thank you so much for those who are taking care of them and making them come to life in this way. You know, when you hear their voice, you are hopeful about our church. Let it not be that when we go, because I am also crossing the Rubicon for the elderly. I'm young and I'm old too. So, because let it not be that when we go, everything will shut down. No. That's always the prayer of every parent, that there be someone to replace when they are gone. So we continue to pray for them, that the spirit of the world will not capture them. Rather, let the spirit of Christ capture them and keep them for God. Thank you so much for everything you do for this parish. And you being present here is encouraging, because we are a community. And after this Mass, I hope we have coffee and donut to garnish the whole thing. Thank you. Thank you. Because food and drink has a way of bonding us. Thank you. The Lord be with you. And Almighty God bless us in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Thanks be to God.
Our closing song is Somebody's Knocking at Your Door, number 34 in the Lead Me, Guide Me hymnal, number 34.